on in. Happy Tuesday. Give a few of y'all time to come on in. Welcome, welcome. Hey, my sister Giselle. I hope you had a good night. I'm listening to Ooh Child by Donnie McClurkin featuring Kirk Franklin. These are two of my favorite gospel artists, and I'm listening to them. Come on in. Hey, my cousin Brenda, come on in. I'm so glad to see you all. Don't forget to share with your page. Share with the people that you know, so they can be blessed too. For joining me today. I appreciate you. And I appreciate when you share. We know things are going to get brighter. We've had a dark previous year, but God is good and the light is starting to come. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started. I am excited today. Well, I'm excited every time I get a chance to come on, be before you all on Testimony Tuesday. As we all know, this is Testimony Tuesday, and so we thank God for opportunity. I want to thank my listeners for listening and those who share, those who listen to the replay. I really appreciate you. My name is Anita J. Merchant. I am known as the Prayer Advocate. I am a certified prayer intercessor, and I am sold out to prayer. Everybody who knows me knows I talk about prayer. I believe in prayer. I am sharing about prayer. I open my mouth, and it's always about prayer. And so today on Testimony Tuesday, it's all about prayer. Now, I want to share with you all two things I want to share with you all. You know how we do it. We acknowledge somebody, we send a shout out, we give away something, and it's all about prayer. And then we have a testimony before we go into what the Holy Spirit led me to live with, to share with you. So today, I want to give a shout out first to all of the graduates of 2021. We know they've had a rough year in 2020. We know that they had probably struggled to get where they are today due to the pandemic, limitations on things that they had to deal with. So we want to just shout out to all of the graduates of 2021. I want to give a special shout out to a special graduate of 2021, my great niece. Her name is Kayla Briggs Jones. She graduated with honors from Peabody Magnet High School. Yay, War Horses. That's my alma mater. I graduated from Peabody Magnet High School. Anybody who knows about Alexandria, Louisiana, or the state of Louisiana, they know about Peabody Magnet High School. So I want to send out congratulations to all of those, and a special shout out to my great niece, Kayla Briggs Jones, who graduated with honors. Smart, smart girl. And so we're going to keep her in prayer that God continues to keep her mind and use her and send her in the direction that she should go. I have a quick testimony, and this is a fun testimony. This is a good testimony that I have, okay? And so here's what the testimony is. So I had my granddaughter this past weekend. You all know that's my heart. Y'all know how much I love my granddaughter. And so we were walking through the store, and we were just picking up a few items. I always try to let her pick something that she wants to pick. I always encourage her to always give something to someone else. And so she said to me when we were in the store, she says, Mama Joy, she calls me Mama Joy. She said, can I just pick something for you? I was like, well, sure, baby, you can pick something for me. And so with her in my peripheral vision, I kind of watched to see where she was going to go. And guess what she did? She's been hanging around me a long time. And so what she did was she went and she picked this up. I'm going to show this to you guys. It's called a grandma jar. And it says world's best grandma. But what really touched me was she said, Mama Joy, if you look inside of it, there's some cards that I can write some notes to you and put in the jar. And so I was like, okay, let me see, Arbony. Let me see. So I opened the jar and proceed to see that these little cards are in the jar. These little cards are in the jar. And you can write a note on the front. You can write a note on the back. And so she says, each time I come and visit you, I can write you a note. Isn't that sweet? And so I thank God how he will use little children, his children, to bring joy into our life. And so that just made my weekend with her when she gave me this grandma's jar. And she's going to write something in it every time she comes and visits with me so that I can have something that I can look at to remind me of how sweet and special she is. So I had to share that testimony because that testimony is exciting for me. That has really made my weekend with her, and just, you know, just to know that she was touched to say, let me get something for you, Mama Joy. So that's my testimony for the day, how God used my granddaughter to bring some joy into my life just for that moment of being thought of and saying that she wanted to get me something. So she did. She wrote me a little note. She says, I love you. She drew a little face, and it said it has her name on it. This is her handwriting, praise the Lord. And then she wrote something on the other side. Isn't that sweet? So we know grandchildren really completes the life of circle of love in our lives. You know, we love our children. We love our friends. We love our acquaintance. We love other people all the time. But we are so touched. Those of who are grandparents can relate. And even those who are not, who are being around children, can relate how children will take your mood and just change it completely for the better. You know, children will just give you something to make you smile and be happy about. So I wanted to share that as my testimony for today's Tuesday. So now I want to go into, we're going to give away another prayer box, All Things Prayer. This prayer box that's going to be sent and mailed to the person is very simple. It says something special on the top, and it's going to include things that are dealing with helping you with your prayer life. Remember, the prayer box is All Things Prayer. And so here's what you have to do to be considered for the prayer box. I just want you to post a prayer, a simple prayer, to my page only. I just want you to post a simple prayer. Just post the prayer. Tag me so it'll come up on my page, and I will see and read the prayers. We have to start praying more, writing the prayers out, and getting before God. That's why today's topic ties into what I'm saying here. Today's topic is about trusting prayer. That means, and I'm asking this question, do you trust your prayer life? Do you really believe in your prayer life? Do you really believe in what you are praying? Do you really know that your prayers are being heard? All of those are questions that you can ask yourself about your prayer life. But we know that prayer is a two-way communication. You listening to God and you going to God. That's the simple step. It's a two-way communication. And the most powerful tool that God has left us and given us opportunity, given us an open door to use in a time of not just need, but in a time of gratefulness and in a time of being honored and being just grateful for what he's done. And so we use prayer as that tool to talk to God and to allow God to talk to us. But how do you really feel, and how do you know, and are you trusting your prayer life? Now, I'm asking these questions because of a simple thing. How do we trust other people? Do we just trust people just to be trusting them? We just trust people because we see them. We just trust people because we just want to trust people. Well, no, it's probably no to most of those questions that I'm asking you. And I'm saying it's because we tend to start trusting people when we're around them, when we're spending time with them, when we're listening to them, when we are asking them, or when we've seen something that they've done. 9 times out of 10, on a consistent basis, when you're in the presence of someone, you start kind of trusting them. You start trusting what they say. You may even trust what they do without even really fully knowing them. But just because you were spending time with them, you were around them, or you even heard someone else say something, you start trusting them. Now, on the flip side of that, do we do that when we're trusting our prayer life with God? Do we just trust God when we go to Him in prayer? How do we go to God in prayer? Do we just trust it because the Word of God say we're supposed to trust Him? Do we just trust our prayer life because we open up our mouths and we pray? How do we really know that we are trusting our prayers? How do we really know we are trusting that we are going to God with that boldness, as He say, comes to the throne of grace in boldness? How do we really know? Have you ever stopped and asked yourself, am I praying because I trust my prayers? Am I praying because I trust my prayer life? Am I praying because I trust God? Am I praying just to be going through the motions? Am I praying because people say we're supposed to pray? How do you know you're really trusting your prayer life? I'm asking this question because I want you to start really thinking about your prayer life. I want you to really start thinking about, how do I pray? How do I come to God in prayer? Do I really believe what I'm asking? Do I really believe what His words say? But how do I know all of these things, Anita? I'm glad you want to know, and I'm glad you want to know the answer, because I'm going to help you out with this. In my spare time the other day, I was just pondering, asking God, God, how do your people really trust you? How do they really trust your that they when they're praying to you, that you hear them? How are they really trusting that their prayer life is being succeeded in hearing, and that you are hearing what they're asking? How, God? How does people know? How am I supposed to trust my prayer life beyond the shadow of the doubt, beyond wondering if it's heard, wondering what you're going to do with it? How, God, do we tell the people to trust their prayer life? See, your prayer life is going to depend on how much time you spend with God and how much time you spend in His Word. We can't go to God in prayer boldly. We can't ask Him for stuff boldly. We can't even believe our prayers if we don't have time with Him. How do we have time with Him? Getting into His Word, having a conversation with Him, staying in a prayer mode with Him, talking to Him throughout the day. Those are ways that we can know we can really trust our prayers, because we know if we're talking to Him, He's going to respond. Remember I said, prayer is a two-way conversation. So when you need to pray, you will need to know, what do I do when I pray? How do I do what do I do, Anita? And so the answer is to this. You can't be timid and shy when you go to God in prayer. I'ma just say this. You can't be timid. You can't be shy. You can't be wishy-washy. Well, Lord, here I come to you today. Well, Lord, oh, Lord. You can't be like that when you're going to a God who you believe in, who you say you know He hears your prayers. He tells us in His Word that we got to come boldly to the throne of grace. Now, I'm not saying you go arrogantly. And I'm not saying that you go all over cocky and you know, like, oh, well, the Lord, this. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is you got to be humble in your spirit, but you got to be bold with your mouth. You got to be humble in your approach, but you got to be courageous when you go. So you can't go all wishy-washy, well, Lord, you know. You got to go to the throne of grace and say, Lord, you said. You got to go to the throne of grace boldly and say, Lord, I trust. Lord, I believe. Lord, I know. See, you got to go to Him and let Him know. You know who He is. You know how big He is. You know He has control over everything. But the only way you're going to be able to do that is that you boldly go. that you boldly go and you speak boldly, that you don't shy back. You open up your mouth and you remind him what he said. How you're going to be able to remind him, though, is you're going to have to spend time with him, and you're going to have to be in his word. And the more you in his word, and the more you spend time with him, the stronger your prayer life will be, and the more boldly you will go to the throne of grace. See, I don't have a problem going to God and telling him what he said in his word, because I'm spending time in his word. I don't have a problem going to God and saying, you said if I ask that I shall receive if it's in your will. See, you remind him. And one thing about God is what he loves is for you to come at him with his word. Come on, Jesus. He loves when you come at him with his word. When you go to him with his word, he can't do nothing but what? Because his word doesn't come back null and void, but do what he says he's going to do. Now, there's four things I want you to be reminded about when you go to the throne of grace boldly. Don't be arrogant and don't get cocky. Don't even act like God owe you something, because he don't owe you anything. I want to say that one more time. Don't go to God thinking that he owes you something. Well, Lord, I sung in the choir 20 years. Lord, I go to church every Sunday. So what? He don't owe you nothing for doing none of that. And don't be like, well, Lord, you know, I did this and I did that. Are you doing it for recognition, or are you doing it because it's the will of God? See, we can't get caught up in all of those I'm doing this to get this from God kind of thing. No, we do it because that's what his word is telling us to do. Those are the expectations. Those are the commandments. That is the word of being obedient. And so it's four things I want you to be reminded in order for you to trust your prayer life. Trust your prayer when you go to God. And one of them is this. When you go to God, boldly to the throne of grace, boldly to him, telling him what he said in his word, he hears everything you're saying. You can take that to the bank. You can guarantee it. You can put it on your life. When you go to him boldly like that, he hears what you are saying. That's the first point I want you to be reminded about, so you can trust your prayer life. The second thing is, God is going to answer you. He gonna back me up with that. He gonna answer you. He's gonna answer you. He's going to answer you. I can't say that too much more, but he's going to answer you. That's the second point you can do when you're trusting your prayer life. The third thing you can be reminded of when you're trusting your prayer life is it's about him answering in his timing. His timing. You may go there desperate and need him to do an immediate thing. You may go there right away and say, Lord, I need you to fix this. Lord, I need you to change this around. Lord, 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 you know, and he hears you. He's going to answer you, but you have to go to the throne of grace boldly, knowing he's going to answer in his timing. It may not be immediately right at that moment. It may not be the same day. It may be weeks away before he answers you, but it's going to be about his timing. So see, when I pray to God and I tell God different things and I open up my heart and I go boldly and I remind him of what he said, you know, he reminds me, okay, my daughter, I hear you and I'm going to answer you in my timing. So we have to be confident to know his timing is the best timing for anything in our lives. I don't care if we feel like it's an emergency, we feel like it need to be rushed or whatever. His timing is the best timing. That's the third thing I want you to remember about boldly praying. And then the fourth thing is going to always be, come on, Jesus, his will. So, when you know, I always tell people when I'm mentoring people on prayer, just automatically go to God and say, Lord, your will be done, not mine. I know you know the desires of my heart. I know you know I want that child to turn around, that wayward child to come back to you. I know you know I want my marriage to be better. I know you know I want finances fixed. I know you know all of those things, God. Is it in your will to do it the way I'm asking? Or is it in your will to do it at all? Lord, not thy will, your will be done. See, we have to get comfortable with knowing when we go to God boldly to the throne of grace, he hears us, he's gonna answer, it's his timing, and it's his will. So I always encourage people to ask God, God, help me to accept your will. You know the desires of my heart. You know what I need and what I want. But Lord, what is your will. Because see, his will may not be what you're asking and begging him for. His will may not line up with what he has and purpose for your life. His will may not be what you think it should be. His will prevail. And so to keep from being disappointed, I tell people, don't go and get disappointed when God don't answer you right away. Don't be disappointed because he didn't answer you the way you wanted him to. Don't be disappointed and when God takes his time or when you feel like he's stalling on the answer. Don't go and be disappointed. Keep asking him to help you to accept his will, because at the end of the prayer time, at the end of the day, at the end of the situation, his will is going to always be the best for you. You might not feel like it is. You may not think that it is. But once you get it into your spirit, I want you to root this into your heart. His will always be the best will for you. It may not feel good at the time. It may not even be what you even want to thank him for. But I promise you, when you start living the word of God in your heart and your spirit, his will is going to be easier for you to accept. Your prayer life is going to be stronger. You ain't going to have no problems going to the throne of grace and boldly saying, Lord, you said. Lord, you said if this does this. Lord, you said. You won't have a problem. See, I don't have a problem going to God, reminding him. Oh, I thank him all the time of what he said. I ain't got to try to figure him out. I ain't got to try to come up with no questions. I ain't got to try to ask him, well, Lord, what? Lord, you said. And so when you bring it back to him, he's going to do those 4 points. I told you, he's going to hear you. You can guarantee he's going to hear you. That ain't something for you to even slack or lack about. He's going to hear you. He's going to answer you. And he's going to answer you in his timing. And when he answers you, it's going to be his will. I'm going to give you an example. I have been praying for 5 years for one particular thing in my life. 5 years. It keeps coming up, and I keep taking it back to him, and I keep telling him what he said in his word. And see, people get caught up because in our folklore, old culture, they say, don't be asking God for the same thing. Don't pray the same thing over. Don't be repetition. You know, I beg to differ with that. When your prayer needs to be answered, you don't care how many times you go to him and ask him. You open up your mouth and boldly say it. Now, sometimes I even say, Lord, now I know I came to you about this last week, but I'm back again. See, I'm boldly going to him to let him know what you said. I'm believing it. I'm receiving it. And I'm waiting on you to manifest it. We get impatient when he don't answer right away. That's why I was giving you as one of the points to know that you can trust your prayer life is that it's his timing. Don't get caught up in the timing of what you feel it should be. Get caught up in the timing of what he wanted to be. Praise the Lord. How about that? Praise the Lord. And I'm saying that because the Holy Spirit is leading me. There's somebody who's going to hear the sound of my voice, or somebody who's listening right now, been praying for something, been asking God for something. You're starting to slack off, lean off, start getting all disgusted about it. You're like fed up. You're like, I ain't going to ask God for that no more because he should have answered it by now. Or either you don't want to talk to him about it because you're afraid he ain't going to answer it. You can't be timid. You need to be bold, but you got to humble in your spirit. There's no such thing as being arrogant when you go to God. You go boldly, but your spirit is humble. So I want to keep you reminded. Your prayer life, you have to be able to trust it. How will I be able to trust it? Spend time in God's word. Spend time in him through prayer. Quote his word back to him. Tell him what he said in his word. Be reminded it's about his timing. Be reminded it's about his will. And you can trust your prayer life with no doubt. See, I have no doubt about my prayer life. And it's not just because I've been praying for years or because God has anointed me to intercede on others' behalf. It's because I've got it in my spirit and in my heart from what I've seen him do versus what I wanted him to do. Come on, Jesus. Remember, when you go to God in prayer, trust your prayer life that when you go to him, he's going to answer you. When you go to him, he's going to answer you. He's going to answer you in his timing, and he's going to make sure it's his will. We know he makes no mistakes. Now, I have two scriptures I'm going to share with you. You know, I always like to back up what the Holy Spirit leads me to talk about with the word of God. Because I don't want you all to think this is something that I'm coming up with or that this is something that I made up. This is something I'm living. And so here's the scriptures right here. It is, the scripture is Hebrews 4 and 16. I want you to meditate on this the rest of the week. Hebrews 4 and 16. Now I'm going to read two versions. I'm going to read the King James Version and the NIV Version. Okay? So the first one I'm going to read is the King James Version. Again, that's Hebrews 4 and 16. And this is what the Word of God says. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. He telling you in his word, what is he saying? Come boldly. Thank you, Lord, unto the throne of grace. Not weak, timid, oh Lord. It ain't saying that in this verse. He says to come boldly to the throne of grace. It's nothing like going to God boldly. Because see, when you go to him boldly, he knows you are sure of what his word is telling you. Now I'm going to read the NIV version of what the word of God says in Hebrews 4 and 16. And this is what this word says. Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence. See, that's a synonym of boldly. So that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. See, you got to go boldly. If you don't get anything else out of what I say today, you have to go boldly to the throne of grace. You have to go boldly to the throne of grace. And I might be repetitiveness of saying this, but you got to get that in your spirit. I got to go boldly to the throne of grace. I don't go all timid. See, timid means I ain't sure of you, God. Timid means, well, I don't really know if it's going to happen. Timid means, maybe, you know, you get to stalling and you get to stumbling. That's what timid means. But courageously, with confidence and boldly, you letting God know your word says it, I believe it. Your word is telling me what I should do, I believe it. So you won't have to question your prayer life. You won't have to question whether you should touch or trust your prayer. You won't automatically know. When I go to this throne of grace before the God I serve, I'm going boldly because I need to let him know and remind him of what he said in his word. I need to let him know and remind him, oh, yes, I trust what you say. Yes. So keep in mind, when you start struggling going to God in prayer, you're not spending enough time with him and you're not believing his word. Don't let nobody get you confused about that, saying, oh, well, you ain't praying because of this or that. You're not praying frequently. You're not in his presence frequently. Your prayer life probably going to be timid. You're probably going to be wandering with it. You're probably not going to have too many words to say. And the reason why, because you don't know what to say, because you hadn't spent time in his word and you haven't spent time with him. I'm just saying. It goes hand in hand. Just like you would trust somebody you hang around. You listen to what they say. You even believe what they say. You may even do what they say. Why can't you do that when it comes to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to our God that we serve? Just automatically go on and trust him and believe what he say. This week, stop in your business, stop in your tracks, and just say, God, what I need to do? How do I need to change? How often do I need to come? Am I coming frequently enough? Am I hearing your word enough? Am I getting the word myself? Not just relying on my pastor on Sunday or prayer meeting on whatever night you go to the church and have your prayer meeting or my prayer partner or an intercessor. Me, Lord, what do I need to do to really know I can trust my prayer? I can trust my prayer life. I can trust my time I'm with you. I can trust the word. Ask God that today. I promise you he's going to answer you. And you should be able to see a shift and a change because you're going to change how you go to him. You're going to go boldly. Remember, not arrogant and feeling like he owes you something because he owes us nothing. We know he owns all things. So that's not something we even need to question. But to trust your prayer life, come on, Jesus. You got to know who you're praying to and you got to know who he is. And the only way you're going to do that is spend time with him and spend time in prayer. I hope this has blessed you all today. And I want you to really get this in your spirit, because a lot of people are struggling in their prayer lives, or they'll say to me, well, I don't know how to pray. I don't know what to say. I don't even know if God hears me. I just don't know. That should never be a question about whether you know if God hears you or not. That shouldn't even be a question on the plate. But if you know he hears you because you're trusting him from where you've been in his presence and in his word, you can trust your prayer life. You all be blessed today. I'm going to pray before I end this session, because the Holy Spirit is leading me to pray, because some people are struggling with their prayer life. Some of them don't, but yeah, some people don't even believe in their prayer life. They don't even know if they can trust their prayer life. So we're going to pray and go to God so he can start interceding and helping us to move forward with our prayer life and trust in our prayer life. Father God, we come to you today. Glory to your name today, Lord God. God, we worship you today. God, we thank you for who you are. We thank you, Lord God, for your word that you've left here for us to be able to read and to understand, to get our understanding from, to know how to boldly come to the throne of grace to you, Lord. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to know that we can come to you at any time, in any space, in any place, anywhere, Lord God, and we can come boldly, and we can ask you for what we need, not so much of what we want. But most of all, Lord, let us start shifting and asking you, what is your will? We know we need the mortgage paid. We know we need our children to have food. We know all those things, Lord. But let us stop and come boldly to the throne of grace and just ask you, what is your will today, Lord? What is your will for me to be able to trust my prayer life, trust my time and I come and be with you, trust what you tell me and you share with me? Let us come to that place in our lives, Lord God, where we can totally trust you. Let us not have any doubt. Let us not come to you timid and all nonchalant, like we don't really know who you are and the power that you have, Lord God. Lord, forgive us when we are timid, or forgive us when we don't even come to you. Forgive us when we don't ask you your will. Forgive us when we don't even ask you what you want. Forgive us today, Lord God. Lord, and as we continue to move forward and being able to trust our prayer life and to trust what you say to us in your word, Lord God, let us draw near to you. Let us come on to you and come closer to you in the name of Jesus, Father. Lord, there's so many people out there who don't trust their prayer life, so they don't pray. There's so many people out there, Lord God, who do not know how to come to your word and listen and see where you say, come boldly to the throne of grace. So we're asking you to draw us all closer to your word, so that when we come to the throne of grace, we know we can come boldly and be boldly, Lord God. And we know that you hear us beyond a shadow of the doubt. So today, Lord God, we're going to thank you in advance. We're praising you in advance. We're worshiping you in advance for how we're going to see our prayer life shift more and more to where we can trust it more and more and believe in what you say. We love you today, Father God. I ask that you touch all of those who can hear the sound of my voice, those who listen to the replay, those who don't quite even understand. Give them some clarity to be able to trust their prayer life. Lord God, we know if they trust their prayer life, they will do it more frequently. They will be consistent. They will come to you. They will have a strong relationship with you. And so we're asking that of you, Lord God, to send down the Holy Spirit. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. I pray that you've been blessed, and I hope this disturbs your spirit to where you can stop in your busyness this week and start asking God to help you to trust your prayer life more. Because the more we trust things, remember this, the more we trust things, the more we do it. The more we trust things, the more we do it. You all be blessed. Remember, let nothing good or bad interrupt your consistent prayer life. Share this with a friend and share this with someone. And remember, go boldly to the throne of grace. Be blessed. Yes, things are going to get brighter. Trust your prayer life. Yes, Lord. Yes. Bless y'all. Thank y'all for joining me. Yes. Thank you. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Praise God. You all be blessed.